Hello, my beautiful darling loves. Welcome to your love reading for the collective. I hope everybody is safe, happy, healthy, and doing well. For those of you new to the channel, my name is Gina. This is, I have a Cancer, Leo, and Virgo only channel. The links to those are in the description box below. Readings can be vice versa, so flip it, twist it, reverse it to whatever way fits you and your situation. Please be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Click that notification bell so you know when my readings post. I do have a tarot tutorial if you're interested in starting a tarot channel or learning how to read tarot. The link for that is in the description box below. It's about 2.5 hours long. If you'd like to book a reading, the link is below. And if you'd like to check out my tarot and oracle decks, I've got Spirit Shield Tarot and Oracle. Buy one, get one free right now. And I also have Royal Rose Tarot, which is 20% off right now, and this one is running low in stock. Okay, all right, my loves, let's get popping here and let's see what we have for the collective, please. Spirit, tell me about the collective, please. What does the collective need to know today, please? What does the collective need to know today, please? Okay, so we've got pride. We have only you, we have return, and we've got withdrawn. So collective, so what we have here is somebody that knows that you were the one. They want to come back, they want to apologize, they want to make amends, but they're being stubborn. Their ego is, it's killing them to come back and admit to you that you were right about everything. It's killing them to come back and admit that, you know, they do love you and they shouldn't have done those things. So I feel like this person is just sitting alone. Do you understand? They're like, okay, I'll just sit here by myself forever because I'm never going to find anyone like the collective. So I'm just going to, you know, be alone for the rest of my life. We have twin flames here and we've got open heart. So what you have here, collective, is someone that's really ready to open their heart. They're willing to accept the fact that your union is unlike anything else that they've experienced, okay? But with obscurity here, they want to keep it a secret. This person is dead set on maybe making you feel abandoned or making you feel dismissed, like rejected, you know what I'm saying? This is someone that I don't know why they're acting this way. They're not willing to admit, you know what I'm saying? It could also be, collective, that this person is realizing that you're done with them. That may be the problem. That as soon as you got to that point that you were done with them and you did not want them anymore, that's when they had this wake-up call that they're never going to be able to replace you. So their ego is afraid of rejection. So they're like, you know what? I know that the collective was my person. I know I'm never going to be able to replace the collective, but I think it's too little too late. I think the collective is done with me. Do you understand? I think your person is feeling unstable right now. They're living in turmoil. They're exhausted. They're feeling lonely without you. This person is stressed out. They're arguing with people around them because they're in the process of trying to release you and get themselves into a headspace where, okay, I'm better off without the collective. I'll just be alone. Do you see what I'm saying? You know, in time, I'll heal from this. In time, I'll get over this and I'll be able to forget the collective. Just one more here. Divine feminine. Okay. This could be a masculine that's realizing that you were their divine feminine, but they only realize this after they completely and totally destroyed your heart. Because this person wanted to go chase thrills, a good time, ecstasy here. This is someone that you may have caught cheating on you, or they may have chosen someone else over you, collective.
So, I mean, this is someone that shattered your heart. They absolutely broke you. They absolutely broke you. And when you finally get to that point where you have nothing left to give to this person, no more forgiveness left in your heart, just nothing, that's when they realize that, you know what, the collective was the one. Their ego won't allow them to come in and apologize because they have a feeling that you're done with them, that you will never take them back. Spirit, tell me about the collective, please. Six of Pentacles and the King of Swords. The Four of Wands and the Three of Swords. Collective, this is someone that was very intelligent and very good at hiding things from you, but you found out anyway. You found out anyway that they were giving to a third party. With the Four of Wands here, you could have been married to this person. We have two twin flame cards. This could have been a strong soul tie connection. With the Chariot and the Hierophant here, you may have thought that this was going to lead to marriage or high levels of commitment. We could be dealing with a Cancer or a Taurus, or you could be a Cancer or a Taurus. Tell me about the collective, please. Seven of Pentacles and the Two of Wands. They're going back and thinking about the decisions that they've made, the choices that they've made in the past. This person's choice was lust or love. This person's choice was lust or love. And for some of you, collective, you may have found out that the third party knew about you and you had no idea about them. This third party may have known who you are and you had no idea who this person was. Tell me about the collective. Page of Wands and the Four of Cups. Collective, you may have told this person that, you just disgust me. You disgust me. I never want to see you again. I never want to look at you again. I don't give a shit about anything that you have to say. I don't care about anything. You were supposed to be committed to me. You were supposed to respect me. You were supposed to have my back. And instead, with the Two of Pentacles here, you decided to juggle that and to take a risk, and now you've lost it. You decided to gamble with our relationship. You decided to gamble me, and you lost. And now, collective, this person's mad at themselves because they have no future without you. They're mad at themselves because they have no future without you. Tell me about the collective, please. Queen of Pentacles and the World card. That side of you that was loving and loyal and committed to this person is, it's just gone. We've got the King to the Queen of Pentacles, and what stands in between these two is the Two of Pentacles and the Five of Pentacles. You risked everything. You risked everything. You chose lust over our love. You disrespected me. You may have seen conversations between your person and this third party talking about you. Talking about you. Collective, this person wishes they would have never done this. I'm telling you right now, when I tell you this person is sitting in such an energy of regret, it is not even funny. The thing is, though, collective, I have to keep it real with you here, okay? They're not sorry they got caught. They're not sorry they cheated. They're sorry they got caught. With the Wheel of Fortune and the Lovers card, this person may have been getting away with this for quite some time, okay? And I feel that, luck was on their side until it wasn't. Until that luck ran out. They thought they were smart enough to keep this going, forever, and they were not. They were not. We could be dealing with a Gemini. Tell me about the Four of Wands here for the collective. The Knight of Wands. Yeah, this person really did think that they could have their cake and eat it too. They thought they could marry you, live with you, be with you, and you know, look, see, Six of Wands and the Three of Swords. I'm telling you right now, collective, they got away with this for a long time, and they bragged about it. They bragged about it to friends, you know, whatever, you know, yeah, I got the collective, and then I got this little side piece, and this, and that. They really thought they were hot shit for getting away with this for quite some time. They thought that, you know, you were so in love with them and that this was going to lead to high levels of commitment and that they were going to have a financially stable future and everything was going to be amazing. And boom, with the Tower, I feel like this secret comes out. I feel like this secret comes out. You know what happened with the High Priestess and the Fool card? This person got too comfortable. They got too comfortable. They didn't hide something the right way. They didn't hide a message, or they didn't put their phone on do not disturb with that hanged man energy. They got to relax when it comes down to hiding their tracks. Tell me about the Seven of Pentacles here for the collective, and the Devil, and the Three of Cups. Collective, this is somebody that's looking back and realizing, what a douche. I was so stupid. I was so stupid. You know, the Five of Swords here, I got away with it a few times. I should have just let it go. I should have just let it go. You know, I got away with it once or twice. And this happens in all areas. This happens with every type of criminal activity you can think of. You know, you get anyone that, like, you know, I've dated a guy that robbed seven banks, and he got caught on the seventh one because he did something that he didn't normally do. He got too relaxed with not the concept of not getting caught, of getting away with it. Do you understand? I mean, you robbed seven banks. Like, you couldn't have stopped at bank three or four or five. Like, for the most part, if we can get away with something, we will. You know what I'm saying? Until we get caught. And this is someone that is saying, man, I got away with it a few times. I should have just freaking let it go. I should have walked away from it. You know what I'm saying? I should have walked away from it. I should have left this Queen of Wands alone. Tell me about the Queen of Wands and the Moon. But they thought that they could keep this secret forever. They thought they could keep this secret forever and keep this third party situation going. You know, Queen of Cups with the Six of Cups here. Yeah, I feel like this person does feel a strong soul tie with you. You could have children with this person, or they feel that past life soul tie between you guys. Tell me about the Queen of Cups and the Six of Cups and the Three of Wands. They're missing you. This person is missing you something fierce. But every time they try to contact you or talk to you with the Five of Wands, you don't want to hear it. You get angry that this person even has the audacity to contact you. Tell me about the Four of Cups here, please. And the Page of Pentacles in the reverse. You tell this person, I don't want to talk to you. I don't want your apology. I don't want shit from you. I want you to get out of my face and go towards whatever bitch or bastard you were sleeping with behind my back and leave me alone. You're just trying to get over this. You're trying to get over this. You are still, for the collectives that I'm reading for, you are still very angry over this. Very angry. Tell me about the Seven of Wands here. The Seven of Wands and the Eight of Cups. Yeah, I feel like, collective, you know, you're going to tell this person you were committed. You should have not never answered that. This person may tell you, oh, but they hit me up. They, you know. No, you should not answer. You should have walked away. You made a promise to me. You made a commitment to me. Do you see what I'm saying? You made a promise and a commitment to me. And I feel like, collective, with the Ace of Swords and the Queen of Swords, your words are sharp. They're cutting. They hurt. And they're true. They're true. What is this person going to say? Like, what is this person going to say? What can they say? They can't say anything. What response can this person actually have? They got caught screwing around behind your back, you know? And with the Nine of Pentacles here and the Five of Pentacles, collective, for some of you, you might be the breadwinner here, where being with you would have given them a financially stable future, and now you're gone. Like, they've got nothing and you're abundant. Do you see what I'm saying? or collective, this is you just really telling this person, do not ever contact me again. Don't do it. You know what I'm saying? Don't do it, because I will cut your head off. You know, tell me about the Queen of Pentacles here and the Page of Swords. I feel like what this person is looking for, collective, is the old you. That there's got to be something left inside of you of the old days. Like, you, there's got to be some type of love or care, something inside of you that still loves them. Do you understand? And they think that if they continue this line of communication, that maybe, like, they'll get some type of, just a little bit of glimmer of the fact that you still love and care for them. Okay, but with the Strength card and the World card, you're not giving them that. With the High Priestess here, you're staying quiet. So now it's like, as much as they want to come back around, as much as they want to do the right thing, they're not moving, because they feel like, you know, you really just don't care anymore. Do you understand what I'm saying? I feel like with the Emperor, the Magician, and the Empress Collective, this is somebody that's wishing that they would have manifested with you, that they would have worked with you. The Nine of Swords and the Eight of Swords, they're crying now because you're really shutting them out. You are really shutting them out, okay? I feel that collective with the Knight of Swords and the Four of Swords, this person may go maybe 4 days or 4 weeks without reaching out to you, but then they're going to come back and try again. Because with the Ten of Cups and the Four of Pentacles, this person is, it's really hitting them what they've lost. It's really hitting them what they've lost. And they do understand that they betrayed you very deeply, but they still feel that with the Eight of Pentacles and the Knight of Pentacles, that you guys can work it out if you would just forgive them. Do you see what I'm saying? But I think that that's going to take a long time, collective. I'm not saying that forgiveness is not in the picture, but it's going to take a long time. So this person may go from, like, you don't hear from them for a while and then they dip back in. It's just because they're coming back in to dip their toe in the water to see if you have forgiven them yet. Do you understand? Spirit, if the collective should take this person back, if the collective should take this person back, would this person ever cheat again? Seven of Swords and the Ten of Wands and the Fool card. The Magician, the King of Swords, the Wheel of Fortune. Tell me about this Ten of Wands, Seven of Swords, and the Fool card. And the Seven of Wands, nope. Nope. The Emperor here, the Three of Pentacles, and Temperance with the Magician, the King of Swords, and the Wheel of Fortune. This person knows what they had. They know what they lost. This person is serious, collective. This person is serious. They are coming, they would come in to work on getting you to forgive them, okay? On getting you to forgive them. I don't see this person cheating. The opportunity would be there for them to cheat, but I don't think that they're going to. Yeah, the Knight of Cups and the Justice card. This person knows that they have to do right by you. Four of Cups, the Hermit, the Two of Swords. I really do feel like it's going to take a long time before you forgive this person and let them back in. With the Ace of Swords, the Ace of Pentacles, and the Star card, I do feel like there's going to be reconciliation here. I'm sorry. I do feel like there's going to be healing, but it's not going to be for a long time. For some of you, it might even be a full year. But this is someone who's not going to let go of you. Okay? They're not going to let go of you. With the Eight of Pentacles here, they're going to keep on working on this. It might get to the point where with the Three of Wands, you're like, damn, I haven't heard from them in a while. Maybe they've actually moved on. And then boom, bang, tink, your phone goes off. You know what I'm saying? They may disappear for periods at a time, and they just keep popping up because they want to see if you have forgiven them yet, and if they can come in and try to make things right, okay? This will eventually lead to you giving in and forgiving them, okay? And no, I don't feel like this person would make this catastrophic of a mistake again, okay? All right, guys, that's what I got for you. I love you all so very much, and I hope to see you soon. Thank you, my loves. Bye.